This is the universe. That's where we live, by the way. And it is home to some of the most beautiful and powerful things in the entire world. With over 200 billion trillion stars in our galaxy, we can only imagine what beauty awaits us in the galaxy. And this is a Lego brick. And I'm going to be using this to recreate the entire universe in Lego. And what better place to start than our home? In our solar system, there are 8 planets and 1 sun, all of which we will have to recreate in Lego. And I'm going to start with our planet, Earth. It's the 3rd planet from the sun and houses all of the beauties that we have come to know and love. So I hopped into additional Lego designing software called Mechabricks and began building. And I know that it simply looks like a blue and green ball right now, but I do have a plan to make this look even better. Next, we're going to make all the other planets until we reach the sun. Our sun is a yellow dwarf star, and believe it or not, our sun is nowhere near the size of the largest star in the galaxy, R136A1, which is a star over 80,000 times the size of our sun. But for now, we'll stick to ours. Now that we're done, it's time to take our solar system and put it into this software called Blender, where I'll add lighting to the planets, as well as some volume scattering to create an image of our solar system in Lego. But before I show you that, I just want to remind you guys that this is only the tip of the iceberg. After this, we're going to be recreating the pillars of creation, a black hole, and even an entire nebula. But first, our solar system. But now, let's talk about the pillars of creation. The first images of these beautiful pillars were taken in 1995 by NASA's Hubble Space Telescope. The pillars of creation are actually a thick fog of dust and gas wherein literal stars are being formed, and I had to recreate this in Lego. And once I had built it, I once again put it in Blender and added lights to further add to the immersiveness of the build. And with that, we were done with another piece of the universe. Next, we are going to be building one of the most challenging builds I've ever done. A black hole, something that, and I quote NASA's official website, are among the most mysterious cosmic objects, much studied, but not fully understood. So, using many curved plates, I began constructing this mysterious cosmic object. And as I do this, I'd love to talk more about black holes, as they are some of the most mesmerizing objects in the universe, something so dense that gravity literally will pull anything, including light, in. And the scariest part is the largest known black hole is tens of billions of times the mass of our sun.
from the outside. You can't tell what is inside a black hole. You can throw television sets, diamond rings, or even your worst enemies into a black hole, and all the black hole will remember is the total mass and the angular momentum and electric charge. The message of this lecture is that black holes ain't as black as they are painted. They are not the eternal prisons they were once thought. Things can get out of a black hole, both to the outside, and possibly, to another universe. So, if you feel you are in a black hole, don't give up. There's a way out.
Now, let's move on to our final and most amazing build of them all. This is a nebula, a giant cloud of dust that can be created by the explosion of a literal dying star. Believe it or not, the pillars of creation we made before are nothing in comparison to what we are going to build because they are simply part of a nebula. What we are building is that and more. In particular, I'm going to be building this. This is the Tarantula Nebula, by far the biggest nebula. It is over 161,000 light years away, or this many miles away. It contains the star cluster known as Hodge 301, and is thought to be over 25 million years old. And we're going to be building it out of Lego.